Kia ora guys, I'm Mackenzie.
And I'm Fraser.
And this is StudyTime's level 1 strategy video for acids and bases.
We've got a few key topics in this standard. There's acids and bases, atoms and ions, writing and balancing equations, and rates of reaction.
Cool, so in this standard, you're going to be answering mostly some conceptual questions, but there will be a mix of interpreting graphs and tables and balancing equations yourself. So let's get stuck in.
One free M or E mark in the exam is going to be on why atoms form ions and why ions are charged particles. Electrons are arranged in shells, with 2 in the first shell, 8 in the second shell, and 8 in the third shell. Full electron shells are really, really stable, and so all atoms want to get to that full shell stability. Let's take oxygen, for example, which has 8 protons and 8 electrons. Oxygen's 8 electrons will go 2 in the first shell and then 6 in the second shell, which means it's missing 2 electrons to get that full shell stability. Once it's gained those 2 electrons to get that full shell stability, then it will have a charge of -2, because remember, it has 8 protons, but now it has 10 electrons. 8 positive charges and 10 negative charges leads to an overall charge of -2.
For acids and bases, one of the key things is to really understand what exactly a base is and what exactly an acid is. So, an acid is a substance that releases hydrogen ions in water, and a base is a substance that releases hydroxide ions in water. And it's important to know the distinctions between each of these for definitions. Some really common questions ask you to relate the pH to increased or decreased levels of hydrogen or hydroxide in water. And what you really want to be doing for this is saying that if there are increased levels of hydroxide, that it's a base, and vice versa for an acid. Also, if a substance is neutral, what happens is that a balanced amount of hydrogen and hydroxide come together to form water, which is neutral. Lastly, you're going to get a lot of a question probably pop up about identification of an unknown solution, and you're going to have to use litmus paper to do so. Now bear in mind that red litmus paper will change blue when it hits a base, but it won't change for an acid or a neutral substance. And blue litmus paper will turn red when it touches an acid, but won't change colour in a base and won't change colour for a neutral solution. So when identifying solutions, make sure that for a neutral substance, you're testing with both kinds of litmus paper.
One question that's definitely going to be in the exam is writing and balancing equations. There are two types of equations, word equations and symbol equations. Word equations are pretty straightforward. There's only two types. You have acid plus base, giving you salt and water, or acid plus carbonate, giving you a salt, water, and CO2. Once you've got your word equation, it's time to turn it into a symbol equation. So you're going to have to convert words like magnesium hydroxide into their relevant chemical symbols. For example, MgOH2 for magnesium hydroxide. To do this, you need to go to your table of ions and get really, really comfortable with making compounds out of those ions. Once you've got your symbol equation all written out, it's time to balance it. This is quite an in-depth process, so definitely go check out our study time guide for an in-depth walkthrough on this.
So another variation of a neutralization style question is how to produce a salt in a lab. Luckily, the way to do this is pretty simple. So what we do is we add our acid and our base together until we reach a neutral state, and we test this using either universal indicator or litmus paper. Next, what we do is we put our contents into an evaporating dish, which we can leave for a couple days to fully dry out, or we can use a Bunsen burner to dry it out a bit quicker. And what happens after this is we get our neutral salt.
For the reaction rates question, it's really important to understand how collision theory works and also how different things affect the rate of reaction. For collision theory, it's really important to have a one sentence description of what it is. So for example, something like, for a reaction to occur, particles must collide with the right energy at the right orientation. The four things you need to know about that affect the rate of reaction are catalysts, temperature, surface area, and concentration. Remember, for temperature, it's a tricky one because there's two effects. It's important to be comfortable discussing these both when they increase and decrease. They're not always going to make a change that's going to increase the rate of reaction. Sometimes they might make it colder, which would decrease the rate of reaction. So watch out for that one. This has been StudyTime's Level 1 Acids and Bases strategy video. We've covered some important strategies in this video, but we haven't covered everything.
Yeah, so we highly recommend you guys practice 2 to 3 years worth of past exam papers so you get an idea of the format and the style of questions that you're going to be asked. Also, check out our walkthrough guides, which are available free online, or you can buy them in print with next day delivery. That's it from us guys, good luck.